Okay, so we're in Moscow, Russia, and as you know, there's a bunch of sanctions. Lots of American companies have left because of the sanctions. Starbucks coffee is no different. So this used to be Starbucks coffee, and now it's called Stars Coffee. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go in and we're gonna see if anything's changed. So let's go. Okay, let's go in, honey. Let's go. You have cold brew.
We don't have cold brew right now, sorry.
Okay. You have something similar to cold brew?
Maybe ice americano.
Okay, ice americano. No sugar, no milk.
Okay, size?
Small. Great.
Your name?
Edward.
That's all for you.
Okay, okay. Then you will pay, right? Okay. Pay in rubles. Okay, while she's doing that, we're gonna take a look around here. I'm looking at this case with all the drinks. It's the same case that you would see in America. It looks a little old. It's a little old. And then we have where you can put sugar and different spices like cinnamon, and you have a straw, and that's the same. Very same. Now, if you look at the logo, this is Stars Coffee. Basically the same logo. The woman is maybe a little bit different. I can't remember what the one in Starbucks looks like, but I don't believe there's a star. So, there you go. And then, everything is about the same. It's exactly the same. What do you think, honey? Is it the same?
I like it.
What was the last Starbucks you've been to, honey? When? Where?
When we're in Turkey.
Oh, in Turkey. Okay, it looks the same. The benches are the same. The floor is the same. Okay. Great. Oh, and I think you get basically sandwiches. It's more Russian style, but it's basically the same. Yeah, I think Russia and Belarus have better desserts than America. And I'm noticing they have their own signature products. Did you see? It says Stars Coffee. So, nothing's. It's changed, just the name, maybe some of the ingredients for the products. They're basically the same. Okay, let's go upstairs and check out. Come on, go ahead. Let's check it out. It's the second level, overlooking the street, which a lot of Starbucks in Europe have, especially the one in Prague. All right. Okay, honey, let's enjoy our coffee. What do you think? Does it taste like Starbucks?
Yes.
Yeah, me too. My kind of cold brew tastes like it, actually. Okay. OG, you ready to leave? Let's get out of here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's go. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative. I hope it gave you an idea of the sanctions that are happening in Russia and how they're dealing with it. You know, if there's an American company or other companies in the West that are here, they're forced to leave. And when they're forced to leave, you know, with a big franchise name like Starbucks, they usually negotiate a deal with a private partner, and they change the name and do a complete transfer to a private owner, where Starbucks has nothing to do with it. So, okay, that's all we have. Until next time, ciao.